now we're going to demonstrate a little bit of frequency modulation going into CV2. We're going to start with the square wave, since that's where we left off. And then we're going to patch into CV2 this time. I'm going to bring the gain on the CV level at CV2 all the way down. So I'm going to patch it in. We don't hear anything. That's what we expect, because our CV2 level is all the way down. So as I start to bring it in, we should start to hear a little bit of change. So if we go all the way to the top, we get a sound very similar to what we heard before when we were patching into CV1. And then, of course, if we go all the way to the top, we expect to hear the Morse code type sound. And we do. Okay, so I'm going to unpatch that. Actually, I should have left that in. My CV level all the way down. Unpatch the square wave, patch into the triangle wave, and then bring up my CV. Very pulsing type sound coming out of there. And this is at the top of the frequency of the LFO. Let's go down a little bit. Also adjust the CV to about the mid-range. Let's go all the way to the top. So that's what it would sound like if it was going into CV1. Let's verify that. Yep, sounds pretty close. Okay. So we're going to go back to the very bottom. No CV signal coming in to affect the frequency of the A110. And we're going to do a sine wave. There's our patch sine wave. And we're going to bring up the gain a little. Okay. Let's bring it up a little further. Even bring down the frequency a little bit. And play with the CV level a little bit, bring it down. Okay, so we're going to bring the level all the way down. Back to no modulation, CV input. Now we're going to go saw wave. And we're going to bring up CV2. And that's at about the mid level of frequency on the LFO. So let's bring it up. Very similar to the kick drum we heard earlier. However, the CV2 is not all the way to the full level, so if we bring it up to the top, we should get our little drum sound again. If I bring it down, it's pretty close to the kick drum we had earlier. So I can bring the frequency all the way down. Bring CV maybe about the mid level. And you just kind of season it to taste, however you particularly want your modulation flavor to be. Okay, moving right along. Now we're going to do the inverted saw. We're back to regular triangle wave right now, coming out of the standard VCO. We're going to go to inverted saw. Okay, and we're about in the low range kind of area. We're not quite at the very bottom of this, but we're about there, at 11 o'clock, 10 o'clock. So I'm going to bring it up to about the 12 o'clock position. And I have my CB level at about the 12 o'clock position. If I bring it all the way up, we can hear what it would sound like if it was in CV1. So I'm going to bring it back to the mid level. And bring my frequency. Let's go all the way up. So that's what it sounds like to modulate CV2 at full frequency on inverted saw. And that's at the full level, so that's what we would hear if we were coming in CV2. And then all the way to the bottom, we have no more modulation. Okay, so just to review, we can modulate any signal from an LFO or any other control voltage source into CV1, and it will adjust accordingly to whatever the waveform is that's going into it. The difference in CV2 is you can adjust how much of that waveform is fed to the frequency of the standard VCO. And then what about modulating both? Well, let's do a little bit of that. I'm not sure if we'll go through all of them, but we may go through a few here. I'm going to start at the top inverted saw, and we're going to patch and make sure I bring down CV2 and patch into CV1. So that's what we got. Let's go about the mid-range just so we can really hear what this is doing. Okay, so you got the idea. Now we're going to patch another one of these waveforms into CV2. And I'm going to do the triangle wave just because I like triangle waves. Plug it in. We don't hear anything, but that's because CV2 is all the way down. I'm going to slowly start to turn it up. There we go. So what's happening here? Well, the jacks are actually both receiving CV, and then that CV at each port is being summed together and then fed to the frequency of the standard VCO. So I adjust the frequency, I can change our sound a little bit. So I have a few different ways now that I can change my sound because I have two CV sources going into my CV inputs on my standard VCO. I can adjust the frequency of my LFO if I want to. I can adjust the level of the CV2 coming in, so I'm only modulating with CV1. I can bring it all the way up if I want to get both. And I just kind of get it in a position that I particularly like the way it sounds. Okay, so I'm going to unpatch those. Bring my CV2 level down. And this time let's do two different waveforms. So let's try the inverted saw going into CV1. And I'm going to bring it about the mid-range just so I can get nice long sustained sound and we kind of can get what exactly this is, what's happening over here to the frequency of the standard VCO. And then I'm going to patch into the sine wave this time into CV2. And we don't hear anything, of course, because CV2 is all the way down. So I'm going to start to bring it up. I'm going to bring it up again. Frequency, LFO. There we go. That's CV2 at about the mid-level, sine wave from the LFO going to CV2, and then inverted saw going into CV1. And just for a little bit of excitement, let's unplug them, and then we'll switch them. So this is going to be going into CV2, and this is going to be going into CV1. There we go. I'm bringing the frequency about the mid position, 12 o'clock. And I have my sine wave going into CV1. And then my inverted saw going into CV2. With the setting at about the mid level, right there on the level of CV2. If I go all the way up, changes my sound. Or I can adjust the frequency to get a different type of sound there. Okay, so let me unpatch those. So there you have it. Frequency modulation at the LFO-2 standard VCO. Now we're going to talk about modulating CV1 and CV2, but with the LFO in a different position. Now we'll remember that the mid-range for the most part was inaudible until we got to the very top of it. So I'm going to go straight into the high range and let's see what happens to our standard VCO when we modulate with something that we can actually hear. And let's just verify what that sounds like. So we're going to be listening to a saw wave going into the mixer. So that's what that sounds like. And now we're going to be feeding this straight in as a control voltage source into our standard VCO. Let's see what happens to our triangle wave. Very, very different sound. And adjust the frequency a little bit. It's very high in harmonics. So that's modulating with an audio rate oscillator to the CV of a second oscillator. Still considered frequency modulation though. It's just in a higher range. But let's try a different wave and see what that sounds like. So let's see a sine wave in the audible range. Again, high position going into CV1 of the standard VCO. Knob's about the 11 o'clock position. Let's bring it up. Okay. So I'm going to unpatch that. I'm going to do a triangle to another triangle. So triangle modulating at audio rate to CV1. And there we go. So in the interest of time, we're going to kind of not demonstrate the other two waveforms. And we're going to just jump right into maybe doing a little bit of audio rate modulation, but with two waveforms, one at CV1 and one at CV2. This is with both. So again, it's summing the two inputs. Creating a new sound. I can bring the frequency up of my LFO. And there we go. Of course, we have control over CV2, so we can either pull it full control voltage from here, of course in the audio rate, triangle wave to CV2, or we can pick it about 50%, and so it's being added to the CV at input 1 over here, and then fed to the frequency of the standard A110. Alright, so I'm going to unpatch that. And that is going to be the conclusion of the demonstration of the first part, the frequency modulation part of the VCO, standard VCO. Demonstrating earlier, we did a little bit of the, just to review, low frequency LFO signal going into CV1 and went through all the different waveforms. And then we went through what those waveforms sound like when they modulate the A110 at CV2. Showed you what it sounds like when you adjust the level of the CV from an LFO going into the A110. And then we even did a little demonstration of both CV1 and CV2 patched with two different waveforms coming from the A145. And then on the tail end of that, which we just wrapped up, we displayed, or demonstrated, what happens, or what it sounds like, when you patch an audio rate signal into CV1. Patching that into CV1 and then creating a different type of modulated sound at your output. So we went into CV1, audio rate oscillator, and then we went into CV2 at the same time, and then heard what both of those sounded like. So there you have it, frequency modulation with the A110. Now we're going to be moving into the next unit, pulse width modulation. So please don't go away, stay with us, and we will continue our little audio demo.